I'm Thuli.
I'm Zeek, and we just thought today we would just spend a little time watching some of the modern music.
We just figured, you know, give it a little peek, see what the kids are up to today. To start out, we've got Corey Feldman's Comeback King. That's on the list.
You know? Yeah, we've heard a couple Corey Feldman songs. We know the one, I think it's like Corey Feldman and the Angels.
Yeah.
And we saw that one. It was like on the Today Show.
And then, really what his band was called? The Angels?
So it was like Corey Feldman and the Angels, I'm pretty sure.
That sounds like a Wings kind of.
And then the old one of him performing What's Up With the Youth on Howard Stern.
What's Up With the Youth has kept me from developing pubic hair. Ed Sheeran, Two Step featuring Lil Baby. I don't know Lil Baby. Next up, we have, oh my God, this title is so fucking long. Taylor Swift featuring Chris Stapleton. I Bet You Think About Me, Taylor's Version. So it's not just any version. This is Taylor's version. You can rest assured that nothing but her artistic vision is coming through. And that's something that I will be keeping in mind as we're watching this.
Dustin Lynch, Party Mode.
I'm really hoping that it's like a cross between LMFAO and like a Eraserhead. You know. Next up, we have Fly Soulja, I'm an Island Boy, and A Blast from the Past on this next one, in a sense. It's new music, but from a face that I haven't heard or thought about in probably 10 years. It's Psy, That.
Coldplay and BTS. I've never heard of this.
And then to top it off, we have Mason Ramsey, Before I Knew It. Also not something I've ever heard of.
Yeah, I have no idea what that one is either. I actually forget what the genre of that one is. So, you know, maybe we'll land on that one. So anyway, we're going to go ahead and race marbles.
And they're off. Mason Ramsey taking an early lead, but only for about 2 seconds.
Oh gosh, it's Taylor Swift.
Oh no,
in.
Mason's back up ahead. Island Boy! Not bad. How many laps? We got 3 laps on this bad boy.
Holy crap.
A Need for Clout. A Need to Be Heard. A Need to Pay Back Their Corporate Overlord Lizard Gods. This is why they do what they do. Well, it's Taylor Swift featuring Chris Stapleton. I Bet You Can Think About Me, Taylor's Version. Let's pull it up. 7 million views. So you know that to pretty much only expect the best here. All right, here we go.
Let it rip.
I will never forget the first time that I met you. I thought, wowza, that is the most beautiful girl in the world. You had the sweetest eyes.
What a handsome man. 3 a.m. and I'm
still awake. I bet you're just. Is this supposed to seem like really touching? Because he seemed kind of like he didn't even know where the fuck he was.
I can't see shit with these on.
We're doing color stuff.
She stole my fit.
There's a red rose. She's wearing red. She put red shit in the drinking water.
Why'd she eat that woman's drink? Or... She ate the olive.
I love this video.
It's very adorable, and we're all very impressed by
she
that.
She just fucked that shit up. You think about me. The inside of the cake is also red. You grew up in. Do you have all the space that you she gets along with kids better than adults.
Nothing.
A red rabbit?
Have you noticed that these have all been relatively despicable behaviors? She's teaching kids how to flip a bird! Bitch, bitch! Is the love that you had. How did we get to this point?
She changed dresses. That's how we got here.
Oh, now we have a performative element in this music video. Because that was a box that had not been checked yet.
She was still wearing red the whole time. I bet you think
about me. Yeah.
Blew it, you dumb bitch.
This is one of those
Taylor Swift
songs
that whole
where it's
time.
Like,
she was wearing a red dress. No other girl's ever worn a red dress, and that dumbass could have had her. He could have had Taylor Swift, and he fucking blew it. I'm fucking heartbroken right now.
The music video itself also was just very, like, white woman Instagram. And there were just a lot of things about it that I think bothered me, aside from just being aesthetically not something that I find to be very interesting. For instance, the fact that the pacing of the song was interrupted for a scene that also left me thinking, how did we get to this point? There was no, like, showing of the narrative of, like, the evolution of, like, oh, like, you know, he walked back towards the table, but then she was still fuck you. And then, yes, at the end, everything turns red to kind of symbolize that, you know, she still hasn't changed her mind. She's still not wanting this guy back again.
She didn't fold for him.
But the I mean, yes, it is a slightly abstract scene or whatever, but I don't think that that's entirely, like, a license to not show, like, the narrative of, like, what's happening, or for that to make sense. And so for the fact that, like, the same scene where the structure of the song was departed from for the music video was also a scene that was, like, well, how the hell did we even get here? You took this long pause to just pause in that confusing scene, as opposed to taking that time to just show one or two, you know, quick 5-second clips of how we got from the table to this point in some kind of cohesive way.
Overall, I'd say, just to have some concluding thoughts, this wasn't laughably bad enough. This was just sort of something that just seems like forgettable pop music that's gonna come and go, just like all of it does, and that's it. I didn't feel like it was something I'll remember forever, like Patrice Wilson videos or something like that, where I'm like, now I'm gonna be singing Chinese Food or Friday by Rebecca Black for years. But, you know, that was just sort of normal bad.
It's as forgettable as like a car you would see in like a Hallmark aisle or something like that. It's just like you go through the aisle, you see there's a card with like a penguin on it, and the penguin is like has some pun about how he's cold and it's also your birthday, you know, or it, like the lion and he's like eating a gazelle and talking about your anniversary or something like that. And then you see that and you go, that's a joke. And then you leave the store and you never ever think about it again.
Well, anyway, thank you guys for watching. It was fun. Hopefully next time we'll have something that's a little funnier to watch.
If you've seen a really whack music video lately, just send it. Fire it down in the comments.
Yeah, we'll watch it. don't take it too seriously. Again, it's just us having fun, just opinions. So enjoy, and we'll see you next time.